Hello and welcome to this Elon Security training lesson on OWASP. OWASP is one of the most popular tools in Kali Linux and it's included by default. So you just click on Applications, then Kali Linux, Top 10 Security Tools. And there you have OWASP Proxy. So if you just click on that, this is going to launch OWASP. And the first time you launch it, you will get a page like this, which is just showing you the license, so just accept this. And after that, this is going to launch the user interface for OWASP. So a quick trick here to get your browser configured to use OWASP is to click on this plug and hack button. Now if we do that, this is going to launch IceWhistle, which is very similar to Firefox. It's the browser that comes by default with Kali Linux. And this is showing us the plug and hack configuration page. So we just click here on click to set up. And then we add the add-on to Firefox. This is just asking us for permission to allow this plugin. So just allow this. And now we install the plugin in the browser. And once the plugin is installed, we can click on this button that's called click to setup. And as we do this, this is going to set up plug and hack for us. So essentially, this is plug and hack is a Mozilla standard. And what it does is it allows you to very quickly configure the browser to use a man-in-the-middle proxy like OWASP. But at the same time, what it's going to do is it's going to accept the SSL certificate from OWASP into the browser so that you don't get any warnings on the browser as you, even if you are using an SSL website, as we will see now in a second. So this is why you get this warning, because this can be a security concern. So you just click on I understand and enable. So at this moment, plug and hack has been configured, and we can verify this simply visiting demo.testfire.net, which is a website we will use in this demo. And now as we have browsed to this website, we can click here and we can see that the traffic has been intercepted by OWASP. So just clicking on this plug and hack button was enough for us to be able to man in the middle HTTP traffic. So we can click on this and we can view the request and the response. Okay, and now a very important thing to do at the beginning when you're looking at our website, for the security of our website, is to spider the website. Okay, so humans are better than tools for this, but the problem is visiting manually everything is very time consuming, like doing this and this, right? So a trick here for to help you to do this step is to click on Tools and then Add-ons, and there's an add-on called SnapLinks Plus, so we can just search for SnapLinks, and there it is. So SnapLinks Plus, and if we install this, this is going to let us browse the website manually much more quickly. So we just click here on restart now to restart the browser with this SnapLinks Plus plugin. And now we just close the add-ons page. And once you have SnapLinks Plus installed, you can right click like this. See? And then SnapLinks Plus is going to click on all those links for you. So this is much more efficient than clicking on everything manually. I'm just using now Control W to close all these tabs. But this is just to show you that it is very quick to browse the site manually like this. And we will be using the login to demonstrate a couple of things with Zap. So if I try to log in with test and test, and I click on login, and here's to say that I don't want to remember the password. It says the login failed, but if you pay attention, you will see that the username was displayed again. So you can use the tactical fuzzing in Zap to verify this vulnerability. So if we go to Zap and then in bank and login, we can see the post request here. So this is the request, and what we can do is we can fuzz the username. So we just select the value we used, test, and we can right click on this and click on fuzz. And from here we can simply choose one of the cross-site scripting dictionaries. So this is JBRO, fuzz, and XSS. And in here we're just going to use the XSS 101 dictionary, and we click on fuzz. So this is showing us the fuzzing results. So we can click here to see the results, and we can see that this parameter is vulnerable to cross-site scripting because it's reflecting back the value. Okay, so what we can do, for example, well, you can do this from anywhere in Zap, but you can right-click and then click on resend, and this allows you to modify the value. Okay, so we can select this, and in here we can just terminate the tag where the injection happens, and here we can use simply a cross-site scripting payload. So we can copy this because we will use it later, and now I just click on send, and in the response we should see if the HTML has been broken or not. Okay, so we can see here that we closed the input text of the UID field, and we injected our own HTML tag, so this is vulnerable to cross-site scripting, and we found this using the tactical fuzzer here. So we were specifically fuzzing that field, and one thing we can do now is we can go back to the browser and we can try this in the username, which I copied before, and we can try any password. And at the same time that we try this, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to enable a global breakpoint in Zap so that this is intercepted and we can see it. Okay, I'm going to create one global breakpoint on all requests and another one on all responses. So now as I click on login, you can see that the browser is stuck, is connecting, and this is because we have set up Zap to intercept the request. So we can go here, and you can see that the break tab is being highlighted, and this is the URL encoded form of our payload. Okay. Now if we click on play, this is going to continue until the next breakpoint, which is the breakpoint on the response. And now if we scroll down a little bit, we should see what the website is returning. Okay, says login fail. And now here on the username, we can see that the HTML is being broken. Okay, and still the browser is stuck because we still have here the breakpoint. We could change here the page as well. And now, as I click on play, the response goes back to the browser. So if we go back to the browser, we can see that our cross-site scripting payload worked. So we get this alert one. Okay, so this shows you a little bit how to intercept traffic, how to use the breakpoints. So we click on OK on this. And then another thing that I want to show you is you could as well just right click here, click on attack, and then attack active scan single URLs. So this is just going to launch the default attacks against this page from the history, and this is much quicker than scanning the whole website. Okay, so this is trying now a few requests, and these were the vulnerabilities that were being found by Zap passively. So X-frame options is not set. There is JavaScript being loaded from a different domain. Okay, so this is demo.testfire.net, and it's loading JavaScript from demo.analytics.testfire.net, and you can see here that Zap has found cross-site scripting and SQL injection on this URL that we are scanning. Okay, and the scan has not completed yet. So you can, as you're scanning things with Zap, you can still do look at other parts from the user interface, and Zap keeps working in the background. Okay, so now we can see what it has found, this cross-site scripting in the username field, which we saw before, but there's also a SQL injection in the password field. Okay, and we get all these SQL errors on the page. So we can see that there's probably a problem with this SQL query. And okay, and now the active scan has finished. So that shows you a little bit the automated vulnerability scanning features in Zap. We've seen the fuzzing as well, and now what we can do is I can show you the Ajax spider. So we can click on another thing I want to show you is here we can see that the safe browsing, another request that we don't really care too much about. So we can click on the first, then hold the shift key and click on the last, right click on this and delete. So you can delete things that are not interesting for you from the site map that Zap gives you. And now what we want to do is we want to show the Ajax spider. So this is a very cool feature in Zap, because it's going to open up the browser and it's going to crawl the website with the spider, but using the Ajax spider, which is following JavaScript and everything. So if we click on this, now this is going to open the browser, and it's pointing it to this website, and it's using JavaScript events and JavaScript information in the DOM in JavaScript to crawl the website. So this crawler is a little bit slower. It's a very useful spider, but it's a little bit slower. However, it's going to probably find more links than the traditional one. Okay, so we can close this, and now we can go here to the Ajax spider tab, and we can see all the URLs that have been found by the Ajax spider. Now another thing that we can do is, for example, if we go back to the alerts, okay, there's cross-site scripting and it's reflected, and this is the URL. Okay, so I can go here, and I can see first here on the request that this is a post request, so we can click on this and we can copy that, and now we can open command window, and here we can verify this using curl. So I'm just using curl and pasting this, and now because this is a post request, we can specify this payload using the data command line option. So I can do it like this, and this is showing us all the HTML. Okay, but we can see here that there's the alert one. So one thing we could do to verify this vulnerability is to do curl and all this, and then we can grep for the alert. Okay, and now we can more easily verify that the alert is there. Okay, another thing we could do is if we go here to the SQL injection, okay, we can see that there's SQL injection on the password field, and this is the request that Zap sends to find out vulnerability. Okay, so we can do the same thing. We can go to curl, we can paste this, and this is a post request. So we can use the data option as well, and we can paste it like this. Okay, and now we get all these SQL errors. Okay, but in this case, let's say that we don't care too much about the HTML because we are not looking for, we are not really looking for cross-site scripting. So what we can do is we can use links and use the standard input option and use the dump option, which will return the interpreted HTML in text form for us. So this is a little bit easier to read. Okay, and this is what it looks like. So we get the summary and we get the error message. And of course, you can as well try this from the browser. So we can copy this and see the password was a single quote. So we can go here, go to online banking. And this is because we had the global breakpoints. This is why the browser was being stuck. But we can just disable that, and now we click on play, and now there are no breakpoints. So this is the username I'm trying, and I'm trying now a single quote here. Never remember passwords for this site, and now we get the SQL error message in here. So this makes it seem that the SQL injection on this parameter. So we can find all these problems using Zap. Okay, so this is a vulnerability that was found with Zap, and we verified it manually using the browser and using curl. Then another thing to note is that Zap has many more options, so you just can go to help and then click on the Zap user guide, and in here you have a lot more options where you can learn more about Zap. Okay, but this should be enough to get you started. Thank you for joining us.